Hi everyone, welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow us to stay up to date. Today we want to cover the whole process of when a patient comes into the clinic until he has his crowns. This procedure can be broken down into a few steps. The first step is the diagnosis. In the diagnosis, the doctor needs to know if he has enough bone in order to do an implant. The X-ray exam that they would do would be called the CBCT, which is a cone beam computed tomography. CBCT gives us in the end a cut of the jaw where you can examine the height and the width of the bone. You can also see the teeth and you can have all of the information from this exam. In CBCT, what happens is that the machine is making a lot of slices and then the computer collects all of the slices and processes them into a 3D model of the jaw, of the bone, and of the teeth. And you can even have the gingiva and the soft tissues. You can see the nerves, you can see all of the other structures that you need for this procedure. Everything here is raw data. You can have it on a disc and you can have it sent through the mail. The first thing you would do is take the 3D reconstruction of the bone and cut it into three different slices in order to get more information, such as the dimensions, the height that you would need to place the implants, or to choose what implants you would need to place. You can see here the horizontal slice, the vertical slice, and the second vertical slice, which is called the coronal slice. It is from left to right, from front to back, and the horizontal part. You are able to see the front to the back, the left to the right, and the horizontal. We already have much more information because this part we can see in the anterior area, the frontal bone, we can see the height of the bone, the width of the bone, the teeth, and the cut of the teeth itself. In the left to right slice, we can see in the lower parts the height and width of the bone. We can see the teeth and we can see different structures, for example, the sinuses. In the horizontal part, in this case, it gives less information because we don't need to measure anything in the horizontal slice, but these two slices are used in most of the cases. These two slices are not enough because if you want to put an implant not in the back area or in the front area, the slices will not give the straight cut of the jaw. We need a perpendicular cut of every place in the jaw or all of the places that we want to place the implants in. So in this case, we need to make some modifications for these slices. The end result that we want to get is we want to have a perpendicular slice for every dot in the CT. You know what it's perpendicular. You can see the height, the width, and all of the parameters. By this slice, you can choose what implants you should use and how you can restore them in the future treatment. So the first thing we're going to do is make a line that is going through the whole jaw. The blue lines go with the arch of the jaw across all the teeth to this line. We have a perpendicular line that goes each 1 millimeter and every line has its own number. It's a perfect perpendicular cut of every step of the arch of the jaw. So in future slices, we'll know that number 10 is this slice. If we want to place this implant in this area, we could use the slices of number 10. And by this slice, we can measure the implant that we can place, the height and the width of the implant. Here, you can see the reconstruction of the jaw. If we will use only the blue lines that we showed before, but on this reconstruction, we already have a ruler. You can see all of the numbers below. All those numbers showing perpendicular cuts, each 1 millimeter, they have their own numbers. These are all individual cuts. In the end, you'll get a few pages of all of the cuts. In each cut, you'll know the number of the cuts and you'll have a ruler in order to measure the bone. You'll know this is 10 millimeters. You can see in here, you have around 6 millimeters, for example, of bone. In the width of the jaw of the bone, you have about 3 or 4. You can know and choose different types of implants and different sizes of implants for each place to position. It's something that can only be made with a CBCT X-ray and not with any other technique. Now that you know where you want to place the implant and which implant you can place in this position, you need to know how to place the implants because even in the same area, you can place the implants in different angulations. You can move the implant a little bit forward or a little bit backwards. You have a little bit of a game here. You can see that you don't have the posterior teeth and you know that you can move the implant a little bit back and a little bit forward. There's no one place for the implant, so you can play with it a little bit. In order to place the implant correctly, you need to have some design of the future crowns that you want the patient to have. In this case, we were doing everything in CAD/CAM on the computer. We designed the crowns in the computer. In this area, you design the teeth you want to be in the future. You have the morphology and the anatomy of the teeth. Now, you know the shape of the teeth, and from there, you know where the implant implant should be. From there, you can now make the implantation itself to place the implants. Because you had the 3D reconstruction before and the 3D model of the patient, you can superposition the 3D reconstruction with the 3D model, one on top of another. So you can see here from the CT that you have the bone and the 3D reconstruction of the bone. You have the impression of the jaw that they made, and you superposition them one on top of another. So here you see both of the crowns you designed. These are the crowns of the patient. This is his CT, and in here you can see how to place the implants. You know that the crown is supposed to be in this area, so the implant probably should be below the crown. It's the best place for the implant. Now, you know the angulation, the best position of the implant, and you can see even different structures. The red line is the lowest part of the implant that you can go to because of the lower jaw. We have a nerve that is responsible for the feeling of the lip. So if you use too long of an implant and you harm the nerve, you can lose feeling in your lip. So this is the lowest part that you want. You might even want to use a shorter implant to be sure that you won't go to the nerve. So in here we chose the implants. We know we have a safe space between the implant and the nerve. Our anatomical structure, everything is done according to the crowns that we designed before. The crowns that we know where they should be, and this is why this implant will be positioned perfectly according to those crowns. Now, we can make a surgical guide, or if the position of the implant is very easy, we can position even freehanded. In these cases, we will show with surgical guide. The surgical guide is something that when we position the implant in the program, you can see a simulation. We can print a guide that will guide the implementation process. In the implementation process, the surgical guide will guide the drills, and later it will guide the implant to be inserted in the same position as we placed in the model digitally. So this is why we ensure that the implants will be right under the crown and everything will go smoothly. In here, you can see the program exported to our guide. You can see two places for two implants as we designed those two crowns. You can write the name of the patient and you can do it all with the guide. It goes onto his teeth and then you just drill through the surgical guide and place the implants through the surgical guide. The surgical guide is printed from a type of plastic that you can sterilize before the procedure. And in the surgical guide, you insert metal sleeves for the drills to go smoothly through. Now, in the last part, you have the implant in the jaw. The doctor makes an impression, sends it to the technician, and the technician needs to design a crown for this implant. We're going to show a cementable crown in this case because it's the easiest to explain. In these cases, we have one implant and we want to have a restoration on one implant. So we take a metal part that's called an abutment. The abutment serves as the crown of the tooth. If we wanted to make a crown on a tooth, we will make a preparation of the tooth itself. The preparation would be conical, and onto this cone, we would cement or glue later the crown. So we take an abutment that fit the implant, which was prefabricated in the factory. Then by the design of the abutment, you can make the crown itself. So you just cut the abutment, measure the height of the abutment, process it a little bit, and then you just make the crown in the end. This crown will go into the patient's mouth. This is a model, but later, the next stage that we don't see here is the technician sending the crown with the abutment to the doctor. The doctor assembles the abutment onto the implant and cements the crown. Thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more, and of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you, and see you next time.